plays Mario Kart Wii, like, hours and hours on end, just addicting.
Do you play local, or do you play online multiplayer?
Sometimes when we're bored, and, like, it's at night time, we can't really go over and see each other, we'll play online against everyone. We'll have fun. It's awesome. You know, online's actually surprisingly good for Wii as well, which is impressive.
Yeah, it is. Do you still do the tournaments? Like, the weekly tournaments or whatever?
I did one of those once, but then once I did it, I never really bothered to do it again, because it wasn't that great, but, yeah.
Yeah, same here. Oh, great, so it's my turn. Can I pick two?
Sure.
Okay. For handhelds, it would be Phoenix Wright Ace Attorney for the DS. It just showed me what a lot of what stories in games can do without the same, oh, sorry, the princess is in the castle kind of story. And it was just awesome with its quirky humor and objections. And then I guess console, I would have to say it would be Okami for the Wii. I love the art style and just the combat. I know couldn't be. I totally forgot to say this. Thank you for reminding me, Carl. Objection! I can't yell at the top of my lungs because I'm in a private home with other people in here, so I don't want them to look at me down the hall and be like, "What the heck is he doing?" But it is such a great game. And speaking of Okami, it just the combat, even though it might take some getting used to, it's just an all-around great game with some unique art style and a very interesting story. So you can grab it for cheap now. So, and just to let everyone know, in case they think that Phoenix Wright is a GBA generation title, it was ported to the DS, and then it's also ported to the iPhone, and it's also ported to the Wii.
So pretty much both of your games, your favorite games of this generation, Phoenix Wright and Okami, were actually last generation games.
Not really, since they're both ported.
Okay,
but
so non-ports, what's your favorite game this generation?
Well, think about this, but like I said before, Phoenix Wright is not really a GBA port because it never was released in North America in English until the DS. So technically in North America, it is a current generation. But if I had to pick another game, I guess it would be Hotel Dusk for the Nintendo DS, because if it wasn't for Hotel Dusk, I would have never gotten into Phoenix Wright. And it was a very unique way to hold the Nintendo DS like a book and to walk around, and it was just... and solve the mystery. It was just very unique in the way its art style was moving. And it was just really fun.
So if you like visual novel type games, I think you'll love 999.
Yeah, I've been looking into 999, and then Europeans get Last Window, which is the sequel to Hotel Dusk, which never made it here. And I am very mad about that, and I still need to import that. So, yes, it's not fair they get the sequel to Trace Memory, and they get the sequel to Hotel Dusk.
And so. Disaster.
And Disaster. And they get Dalshin the Giant from the Nintendo GameCube.
And so. The Australians. I think also the Australians are worse off, though, because they don't get any of them. They probably won't get the 3DS until 2012.
If I remember correctly, I don't think they still even have Phoenix Wright 3.
I don't even know. I just download it, because I've never seen any of the Phoenix Wright games in any store here. It just annoys me, so I just have to download it. And I would buy it if I could find it.
So you acquire them.
Yes, you have acquired them.
The personal views of piracy held by Liam do not directly reflect iNintendo.net.
Not at all.
Or Joey 2, for that matter.
Shame on you.
Liam, I think you should really... I don't know how the exchange rate for Australian dollar in the U.S. in U.S. dollar is, but you should be able to maybe import it for cheaper than what you could buy in stores.
I don't know.
So if you can, if you have an iPod Touch, you can just make a U.S. account and import an iTunes card and download the first one from the American iTunes store.
Or if you can just continue to pirate them, which is what you'll probably do.
But we do not endorse that.
No, we don't. No.
No. They did not reflect the views of iNintendo.net.
Yeah. No. Liam's not with the site, so he's just some random Australian guy I saw on the side of the road, and I was like, hey, you want to be on a Nintendo podcast? And he's like, yeah.
We were visiting Australia the other day.
Yeah.
Was he hugging wallabies? Was he drunk and hugging wallabies?
Riding kangaroos, stealing.
Yes, he was drunk riding kangaroos and hugging wallabies. Yes, those cute little wallabies.
Is that all the reader mail there is for today?
That is all the reader mail. So that's going to be the end of iNintendo Podcast Episode 1. I actually have an image to show you guys real quick.
Oh, like you can see through a podcast.
Just posted it on the Skype. I think you guys will like it.
Oh, God, I remember this.
What the hell?
So, Joey, or Liam, describe what I just linked to you guys.
I'm scared. I think I've been scarred for life. I'm disgusted. Excuse me, I need to go...
Pew.
Toss my cookies.
So basically, I saw this on Go Nintendo. This guy has a tattoo of Pokeballs running down his arm, but you can see stitches by his elbow, and the Pokeballs, like from his skin, they're protruding. Like he got the tattoos, and they put something under his skin. It's really creepy.
And you showed us this. Why? I think Carl is trying to scar us for life.
It's off on it.
Okay. Oh gosh.
Yes, I do, Jay.
Yes, I do.
So before we end, we're gonna throw in some plugs. Branden has an article series that he's doing. It's called "Never Made It Here," and I just want to tell us a little bit about what you're gonna be doing in the article.
Yes. So "Never Made It Here" is a new editorial series where I will be looking at games that never made it to North American or PAL shores, including Australia. For example, the first one just went up, and it is about a game called Giftopia, and it is a Nintendo GameCube game that never made it. It was originally going to be translated to English, and it was shown at E3 2003 in English, but no word after that was found. The only conclusion people could make is that it was just too weird for Western audiences, so check the article out and listen to some of the music and listen to the Japanese screamo and enjoy.
All right, well, that's going to conclude iNintendo Podcast Episode 1. If you want to send in some reader mail, like I said before, we respond to every inquiry, even if it's making fun of Joey or something. We'll read it off. That's podcast@inintendo.net. Submit some ideas for official name of the podcast, or if you want Liam.
What music?
If you want Liam to make a return appearance. And
Or if you don't want me to make a return appearance. That's fine, too.
Or if you want Japanese screamo as the intro song.
No, we need you, Joey, because, see, me, Branden, and Liam are just too awesome. Your incompetence levels it out.
Oh, okay. That makes sense.
Look at that.
So, become a fan of the site on Facebook. You can find
that. You mean like?
Yes, like, actually. I forgot they changed it a long time ago. Follow us on Twitter and join the forum, our active community boards. And our next podcast will take place next week, hopefully. Hopefully we'll have. Hopefully Chris is feeling better. If not, then Liam will be back in. So that's it. See you guys next week.